I just walked off in one of Phoebe's corsets, and it was as easy as that.
Yeah,
it was great.
Reggae.
The only way I keep this girlish figure. I'm out of training for the show now. I'm just wearing Phoebe's corsets.
It's lovely to talk to you both about Bridgerton. I'm now desperate to go to a ball, which will be in 2020.
You shall go to the ball. You just need a little vaccine first.
If everyone's watching the show and everyone's as jealous as you are, someone will cash in on that.
Yeah, tell me about it. You'd get your little card and you know, I'd come over and write on your card and I'd take you for a quadrille.
I love how meeting a partner back then was so different with all of the dances. Is there anything you wish you could bring back from the 19th century and make popular today?
That's a good question.
Riding boots and a cane. If I could stomp down the street with a bejeweled cane and knee-length riding boots, I think I'd be set in life and I'd be more than happy myself.
I'd quite like to bring dance routines to like pop. I'd quite like to go to like a party or a club and everyone to like know the same dance routine, so we'd all be like doing the same thing. I think that was quite a fun thing about that time period. Everyone seemed to know the same dance. I want to do that. Let's bring that to 2021.
Extravagant garden parties. I really, really appreciate an extravagant garden party from Bridgerton.
Yeah, I would second that. And I would also say the way they used to court people, I wouldn't take all of that and bring it to modern times, but there's a big tradition for them to go to the ball and then kind of you dance with who you like. And then the next day they come and bring you gifts. And I'm like, that could 100% be brought
genius.
Back. Imagine you're hungover and someone comes to your house with a McDonald's who like, yeah, it was cool hanging out with you last night. But then another guy comes and brings you a puppy. And I'm like, this is great. That was great. When did that go away? Because let's bring that back. 2021, bring me puppies when I'm hungover, please. Thank you.
Yeah, give me all the gifts.
Yeah.
Can we bring the fashion back? Who knows? I mean, Adam Ann did it, didn't he? There's the sense of tailoring and the care and the, you know, these gents would go and, you know, have their drinks in the evenings and they'd go and live their debauched lives, and they'd come back into their family homes and they would spend, you know, hours in the morning being dressed and being coiffured. And I think the idea of taking real pride in tailoring, I think I'd like to bring forward.
I mean, the costumes and set are just incredible. Did you manage to steal anything?
Do you know, I tried so many times, but you just sort of got rugby tackled every time you got near the car. It didn't help trying to, you know, steal my horse. And top hats are really hard to take though. No, the one thing that I really, really wanted was the signet ring. I wasn't successful there, but I did manage to get his pocket watch. There was a really beautiful sort of suede holder for that. So I managed to get that. Who knows what'll happen in the future? I'll just take big IKEA bags and go for gold.
Yeah, I don't think you could get away with the horse though.
No, unless you put some sort of polystyrene on their hooves and did it at night so no one could hear it.
My family always say stuff like that. They're like, did you get to keep any of it? And I'm like, Mum, when am I going to wear this? When am I going to wear this mask? Where am I going? Down the Queen's arms in my full dress.
Like a small flat in East London, I get my Regency ball gown out. But that would be really good when your friends would be like, yeah, surprise! That would be nice. So the only thing that I have from set is a dance card from the first ball of the season, Lady Danbury's ball with a pencil on it, which I asked to keep. I didn't just steal it. But if series two does come along, I guarantee you I'm going to steal more stuff this time because I want it.
Nice. I love how like Netflix are on this call right now. Like this.
I mean, I'm kidding. It's really sad because I did mean to steal a corset because we had these wonderfully amazing corsets made by Mr. Pearl, who's sort of a corset icon. My plan was to steal a corset and it didn't quite work out. I never managed to get it under my coat, but you know, you never know. Maybe I'll have the opportunity
no
again.
No one expected it. I just walked off in one of Phoebe's corsets and it was as easy as that.
Yeah.
It was great.
Reggae.
The only way I keep this girlish figure. I'm out of training for the show now. I'm just wearing Phoebe's corsets.
The society papers is almost a bit like what social media is today. I was wondering, how obsessed do you think your characters would be with things like Instagram, TikTok, Twitter?
I don't think Eloise would be interested in any of it. I think she'd find it.
I think she'd have like a really angry Twitter account. I think
maybe Twitter.
Reading everybody to filth on Twitter, being like, ugh. This stupid ball I had to go to.
Nice. I don't know how she'd feel about like TikTok. I don't know if she'd be, but maybe she'd have like a nice sort of political Twitter account. Yeah,
I could see that. I think Penelope would be more of a lurker. I don't think Penelope would post very much, but I think she would just stalk Colin Bridgerton's Insta page and like very, very old posts and then panic about it. But yeah, I don't see her posting. I think she would remain sort of mysterious. I don't think she'd be a selfie girl in any way.
Just like number one stalker.
Number one stalker, yeah. Would know what's happening, what everyone else is doing, but not herself.
I think Stone would be 100% a technophobe. I think he'd have not just a tinfoil hat, he'd have like tinfoiled the entire castle to make sure that no Wi-Fi waves could get in. He'd have like a wired old school, like dial it around the edge type of phone. I think he would be full grump on technology.
Yeah, I imagine Daphne would probably be in on, I don't know if she'd be on Twitter, but I think she'd probably be on Instagram. And she'd just be taking pictures of everyone. Probably a few selfies along the way until she found a match.
I was just talking to your co-stars before and they were saying that they think Penelope would just be the biggest Instagram snoop.
Oh yeah. Oh, 100%.
Yes, in a word.
That is so good. I think the thing with Anthony is that I think probably Hyacinth would be roping or the whole family into doing TikToks left, right and centre. And I think Anthony would be that annoying one at the back and just sort of, you know, just be sighing and eye rolling. But I don't think he'd be all about it, but he'd have like a really curated Instagram. He'd do everything he needed to do in order to turn heads, and I think he would probably retreat and hide other than that, and he probably wouldn't even have the app. He'd be one of those people who is on social media but doesn't have the app. You know what I mean?
Please tell me that the rap party was just as fun as all the balls looked to film.
Aww. But we danced, we had a dance together.
We had a dance, we definitely did. They showed us a little bit of the show, which is always the bit that you're like, because you can't believe what you've made, and it's not edited properly and there's no music, but it's still like so exciting because it weirdly, you're in such a bubble when you're filming that you kind of, you don't forget you're making a TV show, but you reach a funny bit where you're like, you don't realize anyone will ever see it. So to see it on the screen, you go, oh, it is real. Oh, it is a thing that we did. And now that's going to come times a million when it goes on Netflix, I guess.
It's a really sexy show, and the balls were just brilliant. The Jack Murphy was the choreographer, and he had these amazing dancers, some of whom I'd worked with in theatre before. And the talent there was no end to it across the board and everyone who was on set. So when we all got given a few free drinks and a modern discotheque, it went off. Thank God for that, because I think at the end of, you know, living in the 19th century, to be able to just be plonked all on the dance floor was pretty special, yeah.
Did you find yourself like using some of the language that you were using in the series in everyday life after filming?
I dare say we shan't know what you're talking about. Nah, not so much. You kind of, one of the joys of doing a job like this, you get to shake it off afterwards. You kind of been somewhere very far away and then you come back and do something thoroughly modern to shake.
Yeah, you end up going the opposite way. I sort of ended up speaking in like monosyllabic, like,
yep.
Good, what about you, you know, text chat.
I think I found myself, I think he's, Anthony's quite held and he sometimes speaks quite, you know, quickly and you know, so I think my sort of muscles around my mouth were either used way more on set or less than, so I think that's sort of, I don't know. Yeah, it was a bit like that. It looked like I'd had sort of lip filler.
Well, thank you so much for talking to me, guys, and huge congratulations
on
the series.
Thanks, Olivia.
Thank you so much.
Bye. Take care.